Okay, here's Pete.
Electronic Stability Program is there to try and prevent the car from skidding. So you have sensors on the vehicle that recognise the individual wheel speed, the yaw sensor, or the movement of the vehicle, and the steering. So we're recognising my steering input, the sideways movement of the vehicle, and the individual speed of each wheel. Now that is sent via pulses to a module on the ABS unit, and that in turn is able to apply a variable braking pressure on the individual wheels to A, stop the car from skidding, and secondary, actually to try and help me steer back on my desired course. Okay, so we'll put it to the test. I'm going to do a lane change down here. I'm not going to brake at all, because the scenario is I'm driving at 35 in a built-up area. Child runs out between two parked cars. My reaction as a driver is a reflex, and that reflex is actually to swerve to avoid. It's not brake, it's to swerve to avoid. And that manoeuvre alone will make the car unstable. And before I even get onto the braking myself, the system will already have kicked in and we're braking the individual wheels for me.
And you're not okay? Going to touch your brakes?
I won't brake at all for the whole manoeuvre.
Right.
Now, I suggest to the driver you do brake, but in a live situation like that, there'll be a delay. For you to recognise a hazard in front, relay that from your brain to your right foot to move from throttle to brake, not taking into account for panic situation, will take approximately a second. These pulses activate every 25 pulses per second.
Right.
So that's far quicker than we can react.
Right, okay.
Okay. So we'll put it to the test. So built at speed, 30, 35, hazard in front, but we don't know that at the moment. We're just driving down the carriageway, minding our own business. Driving down the carriageway, nice day. Look up, car pulls out. Oh my goodness. And you could feel the braking, quite aggressive braking, on the individual wheels, preventing the car from A, skidding, and steering it back on its desired course. And at no point then did I brake at all for the object of this test. Okay, happy?
Yes.
It's interesting that on this car, it's an entry-level vehicle, isn't it, the Clio? Mm. And you tend to associate all this technology with the top end of the market, but here we are, an entry-level car. But it is notch extra, so you do have to request it,
yes,
on this particular car.
Well.
The point is, it's metallic paint is a very visible thing, for example, which is, with Renault, for example, is actually the same price as ESP. A visible item like metallic paint is an easier item to sell than maybe ESP. But at the end of the day, I'm not sure that metallic paint could save your life, where the ESP could well do that. Okay, so we've got a car now without ESP, same manoeuvre again. So, nice day, driving down the carriageway, suddenly look up, hazard in front, oh my goodness. So you can see the difference there, that the car was actually far more controllable. I was able to steer back my desired line when the ESP was connected.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome.